I bow to all the seekers of truth. So much has been said, and really my heart is full of gratitude for all of you to come here all the way, and the way people have described about Sahaja Yoga. To understand Sahaja Yoga, we should know where are we today in this Kali Yuga. What are we facing today? It should really make you feel quite disturbed to see the way things are going on in every country, everywhere. What's the problem? What is the such a need for people to become so restless, full of tensions, collectively, country-wise? Anywhere you go, you find some sort of a confusion, terrible. The whole society seems to be boiling with a kind of a fear of destruction. What is the reason? There are so many religions, so many organized, disorganized, all kinds of things. There are so many sadhus and sons. There are so many books written about what you should have. But the only one who is a seeker of truth should see one point. Why? Why there is so much problem in this world, and how can you help them? Where is the problem? It is inside the human being. As described, you see, we have come out of animal stage to human stage. We have a human awareness, no doubt. In that awareness, we start seeing all kinds of things that are not good, which are destructive, which are disturbing. If it doesn't disturb you, that means you are not at all a sensitive person. But you are sensitive as a human being. So now, what is the reason for this? In every field of life, whether it is political, economic, or any field of life in which human beings are living, there's a very subtle problem which people don't understand. Now, if I say that there is spirit within us, which shines in our heart, you need not believe. Need not believe. But our attention is not on the spirit. They call it Atma Vimukh. Our attention is outside. At this stage, at the human awareness, our attention is outside. Outside in various things. Now, where should our attention go? To evolve? For what? To achieve what? Firstly, our attention has now go towards our spirit, towards spiritual understanding. This is one thing has to happen to human beings to begin with. Otherwise, our attention is outside. We are worried about money, worried about power, worried about this, worried about that, in competition and all kinds of things going on. But if your attention is turned somehow towards your spirit, then what happens to you is that you become the power of the spirit. And the power of the spirit is the highest power that you could think of. First of all, spirit is the one that loves. Loves without asking for anything, without expecting anything, just loves. It's an unconditional type of a personality which just emits love. Anybody in trouble, anybody having a problem, just it flows. This capacity to flow in the heart exists. But on top of that is the closing point, is that our attention is not on our spirit. Even in political endeavors or your economic endeavors, any endeavor, what happens is that attention is outside. So you go into competition, you go into this thing, you go on becoming very competent, and then suddenly find another one coming up. There are so many struggles when your attention is outside. Because in attention outside, there is no purity. There is no purity. It's just attention to yourself. And that too is so limited. Very limited it is, because if you pay attention to yourself, there's no end to your troubles and woes. For a person, as they said, really is fact that I don't mind sleeping anywhere, I don't mind eating anything, I am not bothered about all these things. It's a fact. Because, you see, it's not very important, I think. But without thinking, I'm made like that, I'm like that, all right. But Sahaja Yogis have become like this. This is the miracle, that human beings have turned their attention to their spirit. Then you are amazed how things work out. Without any competition, without any fights, without any quarrels, how your attention becomes fixed on your spirit. First, the first thing that happens to you is good health. Your health improves. Firstly, if your health is all right, I mean, so many problems are solved. This world, I think, at least 30% people are always sick because of the tensions, maybe because of bad food and this and that. This is first thing that happens to you, is your health improves. Today now, in Sahaja Yoga, we have people who have learned that by these modern ways of economics and all that, has not given any peace to anyone. We think of America, I mean, I've been to America, I know Americans, how terribly disturbed they are. Their families are ruined, their children are ruined, and all kinds of stupid things are happening. Our Indian gurus are going and making a big money there, and they just want peace. They just want peace of the heart. That's only possible when your attention goes to your heart, because in the heart resides the spirit, and the spirit is the source of peace. First is the love, and second, as I told you just now, is the peace. You become extremely peaceful. You become like a witness, and you see the whole drama like a joke. It's nothing so serious to be worried about. It all works out. And this is what one has to become, is to become the spirit, which is your own, which is in your own heart. And that is the source, as I told you, of love. And again, I say, of peace. And the third thing that happens to you, that the source of spirit being joy, that joy bubbles in your life. It just bubbles in your life. You don't know how to get out of that great ocean of joy. You start swimming in it, enjoying it, every bit of it. You touch all the shores, going around the whole world, their hearts and everything. It is in the heart that resides. Again, I say, it is not in the brain. No mental activity can take you to spirit. Spirit is only possible if your attention could be somehow taken to the spirit. And that's possible only through Kundalini awakening. This change of attitude towards life, this chain of complete peace and joy has come to you all because your attention is now on your spirit. Now you don't think of money. Money walks your way. You don't think of power. Power walks your way. And the power of the spirit is the highest, the most powerful, and the most righteous thing. It is not necessary that you should become a sannyasi, sadhu, baba, do all kinds of things. No necessity of these rituals. The spirit is residing within you. Already all you have done in last lives. Now this life, only thing you have to do is to put attention to your spirit. And that's only possible through the awakening of this Kundalini, the primordial mother. When she starts, I mean, that's also your own. When she starts rising, she passes through these centers and enriches them, integrates them, and pierces through the last fontanelle bone area and makes you connected to this all-pervading power of divine love. But this power of divine love is not only the love, if you want to say, it is also peace and joy. And also it is the superior wisdom. It is rather subtle for normal man to understand, I know that. I have gone through that. For persons to understand that one can become the spirit. But this is in the evolutionary process. Today is the time for people to become the spirit. This is the blessing of this blossom time, as I call it. And people have to become the spirit. Otherwise, what is left of them is like all other human beings who will, I don't know where they'll end up. So this is an essential step today to become the spirit. All the saints, all the prophets, all the religions have talked about it. Not that they have not. Of course, we have twisted them, we have made separate things. But it's only one simple thing is that you are a spirit. And that spirit, unless and until you become, you cannot achieve any peace, any joy, and no love. The Sahaja Yogis here who are sitting have achieved it. They don't think they are from foreign countries or from this country or that country. They don't want, now here it is in this camp, we don't have very good arrangements for sleeping or eating or anything, no good bathrooms, nothing. They are just enjoying themselves. Nobody minds it. Of course, certain things of particular country may linger on. But then it drops. It drops. Gradually it starts dropping out. Like a flower, when it becomes the fruit, all its petals and everything drops out and then it becomes the fruit. So you have now become the fruit. Fruit of knowledge. Fruit of wisdom and of love. For knowledge, you don't have to read books. There's no need to. People who have read too many books are difficult to get Sahaja Yoga. But what you have to see yourself, what is the reality? But that's only possible if you are a realized soul. Otherwise, you get lost in the illusions of the world. You live with the illusions all your life, struggling, fighting, and I don't want to say what's the end is. So a simple thing that has happened with Sahaja Yoga in your evolutionary process, your attention now has gone to spirit than to anything else. As soon as the power of the spirit comes, you find yourself successful in everything. You don't want, you don't ask for it, and if you are not, you don't mind. You don't mind, because you think they don't understand, it's all right, forget it. So there's no use fighting for it, asking for it. For this, one thing is important. First and foremost thing, you have to forgive everyone.